Do you want to know the non-technical skills needed to become a cloud architect? If so, this video is for you. I love the cloud architect role. In fact, I love all architect roles, whether they be an enterprise architect, cloud architect, network architect, or any architecture career. I've actually been an architect now for over 25 years, and I've loved every minute of it. And I want you to have the best success in your cloud architect career or enterprise architect career. And you can be highly successful in your architect career as long as you master both the technical skills and the non-technical skills. In fact, the non-technical skills are at least 50% of the critical skills for the cloud architect role. And as you move up in your cloud architect career or enterprise architect career, these non-technical skills will become even more important. Obviously, as architects, we need to understand networking, data center technologies, cloud technologies, and security technologies, because that's the foundation of cloud architecture. But in this video, we will cover the critical non-technical skills needed for a cloud architect, enterprise architect, or any other architecture career for that matter. To begin the discussion, let's evaluate the role of the cloud architect, and then we will show why these non-technical skills are so critical. As cloud architects or enterprise architects, our job is really about improving our customers' business. So for architects, technology will be our tool, just like a carpenter would use a hammer as one of their tools. Our role involves meeting with clients, learning about their business goals, learning how their business operates, and of course, optimizing our clients' business operations, which means to be great architects, we need a lot of non-technical skills. The first skill is business knowledge, often referred to as business acumen. As a cloud architect, we must have strong business knowledge. Since our role is about optimizing our clients' business, we obviously must understand business. We can't improve our clients' business if we don't understand business or business optimization. The next critical skill is communication skills. We will need to ask many questions to our clients to learn about their challenges, how their business operates, evaluate their current technology systems, and so much more. So strong communication skills are essential, both verbal and written. We'll get to the written ones soon. We also need a skill called CXO relevancy. This really means the knowledge to know what the executive team cares about. And it's about how we communicate to the executives and our clients. For example, we cannot have a discussion about identity and access management with the CEO. When we meet with the CEO, we must address CEO concerns like long-term strategy, enhancing revenue, or improving operations. Now, as architects, let's face it, we're going to be giving a lot of presentations, so presentation skills are a very critical skill. We will be delivering presentations to executives, presentations to technology teams, and presentations at conferences. In fact, presentation skills are so important that most cloud architect interviews end in a presentation, and you better win that presentation to get that great cloud architect job. The next set of non-technical skills are leadership skills. As cloud architects, we'll be constantly leading teams of engineers and specialty architects to help with our architectural designs and proof of concept testing. An effective cloud architect must be able to build teams on demand and lead the teams into successful designs, RFP responses, and even lead our customers into adopting the right solutions. Which brings us to sales skills. As cloud architects, we must sell our designs to the client. It doesn't matter how great our designs are if the customer doesn't say yes to the purchase. If we can't sell the architecture to the client, all we end up is with beautiful architecture documents and beautiful pictures. So sales is the difference between a solution that would be brought to life and one that will never be adopted. Writing skills. As architects, we will be constantly writing, whether it's the creation of an architecture document or a statement of work or responding to a request for proposal, we will be writing every day. And as architects, we must communicate effectively in our writing so we can be successful in a cloud architect job or an enterprise architect job. The next critical set of skills are stakeholder management skills. As architects, we will be dealing with many stakeholders. Stakeholders are people who have a vested interest in the organization's success. This means the company's executives, department heads from various departments, technical teams, security teams, and even various vendors. And we have to make sure that we can get those stakeholders bought in for the solution to be adopted and to be successful. Want to know an even better reason to learn all these non-technical skills? Guess what? These are the skills that can increase your earnings the most. I hope you've enjoyed this video on the essential non-technical skills for cloud architect careers and enterprise architect careers. If you would like to learn more about becoming a cloud architect or an enterprise architect, please join us for one of our free webinars and get one of our free guides. You can find links for these free webinars and many of our free ebooks and guides to assist you in your architecture career in the description of this video. And if you have enjoyed this video, please give it a like and subscribe to our channel to be informed of new videos to help you in your technology career. I look forward to seeing you in another video very soon.